We've got a really great event coming up next. We're going to take a little virtual field trip to Kenya with Old Pejeta Conservancy. But before we do that, I want to take a couple minutes just to touch on a few kind of housekeeping things. We try to build in a little buffer in between each of the events where we can share maybe a couple videos from rangers. We can share a couple organizations that we're trying to raise funds for, remind people to check out the website and things like that. So this festival is part of a series called the Global Biodiversity Festival. So for those who may not be familiar with it, the Global Biodiversity Festival happens every May. And it's all about bringing the weird and the wonderful, the challenges life faces, and of course, some good news conservation stories live to people around the world. So we just had an incredible second year of the Global Biodiversity Festival last May. We broadcast live for 78 hours straight. We had over 160 speakers join us from all around the world, all seven continents, 60 countries. We had people registered and tuning in from over 80 countries. It really was just an incredible 3 days of really lapping the world three times and learning so much about biodiversity and those who are on the front line of protecting that biodiversity. So I do want to share that website link here. So if you want to take a look, it's globalbiofest.com. You can see the lineup from last year. And after this festival, you can check out all of the events, all 150 plus some events are available to tune into anytime in a big Global Biodiversity Fest playlist. So do check out that website and do take a minute to register for the newsletter, because then that'll keep you up to date with everything that's coming. So I did mention it's a series. So we didn't want to wait another whole year to do another one of these, to do another series. So our first event in the series. So we want to have a series of smaller festivals celebrating different aspects of biodiversity. And that's what we're doing today on World Ranger Day. We are really celebrating rangers around the world who really are on the front lines of protecting our biodiversity. And so seemed like the perfect fit for the first mini festival in this Global Biodiversity series. So I did mention we were taking a little virtual field trip to Kenya next. We are heading to Old Pejeta, and we're going to have a visit with the Canine Anti-Poaching Unit. So Old Pejeta Conservancy is a 90,000-acre conservancy. It's located in central Kenya, and it's home to the largest black rhino population in East and Central Africa. It's also home to the last two northern white rhinos, and it's a safe haven for endangered species, including rescued chimpanzees and the Big Five. So it has some of the highest predator densities in Kenya and still manages a very successful livestock program. Old Pejeta also seeks to support the people living around its borders to ensure wildlife conservation translates to better education, healthcare, infrastructure for the next generation of wildlife guardians. So I can see them backstage. I'm gonna bring them in here now. Here we go. Hello, Old Pejeta, how are we doing today?
Hello, Joe. Dylan, I'm here with Tekeles, John Tekeles. He's the head of the K9 unit. Tekeles, you can say something.
Hello, morning. My name is John Tekeles. I'm in charge of pushing K9 unit.
All right. Well, great to have you joining us today. Thank you so much. I know it's the start of the day there, right? It's about 7:30. So are you just getting your day started with the dogs?
Yeah, it's 7:30 in the morning here, and these guys, some of them are from just from deployment, and they haven't had a rest because they were up all night.
Okay, wow. Well, first of all, happy World Ranger Day. Thank you so much for joining us, and you know, thanks for the work that you were doing all night tonight, and you know, protecting wildlife in the conservancy.
Thank you. So can we start?
Yeah, absolutely, Dylan.
So, Tekeles, can you tell us what the dog unit does in Old Pejeta?
Dog unit supports the anti-poaching unit. And also, we work together with the government, especially Kenya Wildlife Service and the Kenya Police, to enhance security within our conservancy and also within our surrounding communities. And also, we support other areas. Wildlife to if any crime occurs, we send our team of dogs and army team. Because we should have a quick response team this year on 24/7. If anything happens within perimeter or outside, we have a team to support any crime occurs within either or outside the conservation.
So how do people from the community reach you when something happens there?
We shall have people within the community. We have our numbers, especially office numbers. But before we take dogs outside, first they report to Kenya Police. They book the case there. So the police call the dogs because we work together with the police. So every time before we send dogs outside, must police know that the dog will go to support the community.
And what does each dog here, because we have puppies, do each dog have a role or they all do something similar?
First of all, we have five big dogs, four bloodhounds. We use bloodhounds for tracking, for poaching. And we have one spring spaniel for searching of weapons and ammunition. And also these puppies, there are nine. Now we have nine here. They are born, they are 12 of one day born. They have already gone to other areas. So we have nine here on training, 2 months on training now. Trained us for tracking of seal human being or poaching. We added more operation. And this is why we have this all purpose. Because we have a new conservation we want to open. We have already have new kennels already built. So we want to send some of the puppies here to support our new conservation before we send rhinos. Make sure the area is safe. So first we send the dogs to the team to make sure the conservation is safe.
Thank you. For the guys who might not know, Olkajeta is the biggest black rhino sanctuary in Eastern Central Africa. And right now, we are overwhelmed with the rhino population. We're trying to save the rhinos from poaching. And the numbers that we are having can't be accommodated with the property we have because rhinos are very territorial. So we have frequent rhino fights and we fear that they might start killing each other. So we got an extra property which is adjacent to the conservancy. It's called Mutara. So this is where Tekeles is talking of us having another anti-poaching unit there before we started deploying the rhinos, which hopefully will be soon. So Tekeles, can we enter into the dog unit?
Yeah, welcome.
So there's one puppy that has come to greet us. So do they all have names or... Oh, they want to escape. Do they have names and specific roles that they have? Because you've talked about some being attack dogs, some being good at tracking.
Yeah. All of them have names. Mm-hmm. Each puppy, before we tell the puppies, we give the names. So all of them have already have names. Mm-hmm. They, some are Milinzi, Diego, Sa, Joe, Suga, Pipa. Every puppy have a name here. Already have the names.
And I can see the puppies look the same. How can you differentiate between the puppies that are here?
These puppies are not, they're all different. For us, there are some places we can, because some are different. Some are white in the chest, some you see are bigger than the others, some are more smaller. So each puppy are different within the other puppy. Mm-hmm.
And how long has the dog unit program run on all?
I think we are among the first Kenyan unit. Conservation, especially here within the UK. We are now from, I think, 16 years old. We have kennels here.
16 years. And are there success stories of you catching criminals outside or inside here?
Yeah, we have a lot of success with the dogs. regarding poaching, cattle theft, and other.
Oh yeah, we are back. Sorry for the internet hiccup. We can move. So these guys are also with the canine unit.
Yes. So some of them is called vegetarian, and some are not. They are here for training for other conservation. So we support other conservation in terms of training of the puppies and the handlers. So you have 8 handlers from other areas for 3 months. I think the end of August, they will go with the puppies.
End of August, we'll go with puppies. Yeah. All of them, or there are some that we are remaining with?
Yeah, we remain here with the 3 puppies.
3 puppies.
Yeah.
Okay. Joe? Hello?
Yes, Dylan?
Does anyone have a question for us here?
Dylan, yeah, so the first question, this may have been answered, but we might have missed it. What type of dogs are they? What's their breed?
These puppies are bloodhounds, and they also you have one spring spaniel. So I will show you the spring spaniel now.
So can we go to the spring spaniel?
Mm-hmm. Come on. Yes. No. No.
I've just been ambushed by the dogs here as we've entered. So these are the bigger dogs. So these ones are already working. The puppies are still being trained. So these are still bloodhounds, right? Take us.
These are still bloodhounds.
Yeah.
This is the mom of the puppies.
Mm-hmm.
Her name is Stacy.
Mm-hmm.
Malaika. And Scuff.
Mm-hmm.
So Scuff is the mom of Stacy. Of Malaika.
Mm-hmm.
They're beautiful dogs.
Joe, did you say something?
Yeah, I was just commenting. They're beautiful dogs.
Thank you. Your dogs are said to be beautiful.
Thank you.
So as they get older, do you interact with them less in a playful way, or can you always kind of be playful with them and they're still really good at the job?
They're still good at the job, even though they're playful, because right now you can see how we've entered and they've greeted us. So I haven't understood your question really.
All right. Dylan, I think now might be a good time to share the video. We've got a video ready here that kind of shows a little bit of the Rangers and the canine unit in action. So why don't we share that video so we can see a little bit of that, and then we can come back and check out a little bit more of the canine unit.
Okay, thank you.
All right, excellent. So I'm just going to cue that video up quickly here, and then we'll take a look at the video. So let's get that loaded up for us. Okay, there we go. That should open now.
My name is John Tekeles. I'm in charge of anti-poaching canine unit. The purpose of canine unit is to support anti-poaching unit, and also we support our neighboring communities. And we work together with the Kenya government, especially Kenya Wildlife Service and the Kenya Police. We use the dogs for tracking of human being or anybody, any crime occurs within the conservation or outside the conservation. But now we use dogs a lot in supporting our communities. any crime occurs in your communities, we use the dogs.
Bull! Bull! Come on! Jump!
We have a lot of arrests using the dogs. I think within this year we have more than 5 raping cases and murder cases. For poaching is a bit getting down, so we use dogs now in the communities to support them. I think we have more cases regarding dogs in communities. We have, again, for I think 5 raping, stroke murder, and we have cattle theft. We have more than 6 cases for only this year. I joined Conservancy in year 2012, and at that time I get only, they have 2 dogs, 3 dogs, sorry, 2 tracking dogs and 1 attack dog. Up to now we have more than 9 dogs, because now we have 5 big dogs and we have 9 puppies. Oh, sorry, we have 4 puppies. And again, we have a new canine here. This is our new canine here. So it's a big change since I come from 2012 to now. I think we have a big number, both dogs and the dog handlers. First time I joined Ranger in 1998. This I was a Ranger, and from 2008 I joined dog unit. So first I expired by my brother, my elder brother was anti-poaching, so expired me to join anti-poaching. And later I like dogs. Before when I was young boy, we used dogs to secure our families, and sometimes they take care of our wildlife, our animals. So from that time, when I get anti-poaching unit, I joined the dog unit. And I think dogs support a lot in conservation, because I work within the conservation community, and still I work to support the government. So this is why I joined dog unit.
All right, excellent. What a great, great video. Dylan, I know you had a hand in putting that video together. So thank you so much for putting that video together for us today so we could see the canine unit in action.
You're welcome. Yeah, you're welcome. So this is one of the dogs here that Tekeles is with. So Tekeles, what's her name or his name?
His name is Drum.
Drum.
Yeah, we use him for searching of weapons and ammunition.
Weapons and ammunition.
Dillian is 2 years old.
And what do the puppies and the dogs, the bigger dogs, like doing apart from working? Because I can see they're so playful.
So most of time when they don't have place to go, just we put them in the kennels and the handlers come and they play with the dogs, socialize the dogs. The dogs like to be some of, make sure that somebody within the kennels to make sure dogs are happy.
What is the cost like being with the dogs and keeping up with the dogs?
It is a bit expensive to have this team of these dogs, because for medication, food, salary of the trade of handlers, training activities. So I think per year, before we add puppies for the last 5 big dogs we have, it's more than 10 million per year. I think it's a bit more expensive to have this team.
To have this team.
Yeah, again, to add another team is it's more expensive.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. And guys can support. We have a fundraiser on the 23rd of October, which will be live at the Royal Geographical Society. On the links in our bio, you can register and come and donate and support the conservation efforts that Tekeles and the other team are doing. So, Joe, do you have anything for us or any comments, questions?
I have a few questions here, Dylan, for you and Tekeles. The first one is about handlers. Does the same handler always work with the same dog? Or does that not matter?
Every handler can handle any dogs. So we train handlers to handle any dogs within the kennels. But some of the handlers have the dogs they like more than the other dogs. But we prefer all handlers to, they can handle each dog.
Okay. Another question that came in here, we just met Drum, and you said that Drum is a ammunition sniffing dog. How do you start? What's the process for training a dog to be able to find ammunition, weapons and ammunition?
For training the dogs for use for searching of ammunition, first we use a Kong ball, we put gunpowder, and we throw somewhere and hide somewhere. So you tell them to find. After it takes time, like 19 months to be ready for this dog to be ready for searching of weapons. But now you can hide just one bullet and he can find. If you have time, I can show you how he's searching, find the weapons.
All right. Another question coming in here is about the patrols. Are you and or members of the team out every night with the dogs?
Not. No, we don't use dogs in patrolling because we lost our patrol dogs 2 months ago. His name is Osirikari. He get a heart attack. So now we don't have a patrol dog. So this which dogs the dogs we have here is for tracking only. So we lost our patrol dog 2 months ago. So now we don't have a patrol dog.
And how often are the tracking dogs out? Is it regularly or just kind of when there's a call?
Have lost you for a bit. We couldn't hear what you're saying.
How often do the tracking dogs go out on a call? Is it pretty regular? A few times a week? How often do they get called out?
More than 4 or 5 days a week, we get a call from outside the conservation. Most of the time, these dogs go to support the community a lot of time within the conservation.
Okay. And then so, you know, what can you tell us a little bit about the morning routine with the dogs? What does that look like when you get with the dog? What kind of things do we have to do each day?
The morning routine with the dogs.
First of all, we wake up. As in charge of the unit, I come and say hi to the dogs, and the handlers come for cleaning of the kennels. After cleaning the kennels, we take the dogs for a short walk and bring them again in the kennels and shake the dogs, play grooming inspection to make sure they are happy before we take for activities.
We lost.
I can still hear you. I've got another question here that's come in. How many years will a dog work for?
Come on. All right.
Did you hear that, Dylan? Yeah.
No, we didn't hear the question.
Yeah. How many years will a dog work for?
They work for 8 years. After 8 years, we give it power here to retire.
Okay. So I'm looking behind you and I see what looks like some training equipment. Looks like a hoop, a car door. Can you tell us a little bit about some of the some of that training equipment?
This, we use this, we call jellies for training of attack dogs or patrol dogs. But bloodhounds, they can't use jellies because they are very much heavy and their bones are not good for using in jellies. So now we don't use these jellies because we don't have attack dogs or patrol dogs.
That's so great to see. What's this one's name?
What's the dog's name?
Malaika. Malaika means angel.
Means angel. That's great. How old is Malaika?
Malaika is 2.5 years now.
And is Malaika the mom to the puppies?
No. Stacy, come on, girl. Stacy, come on, girl. Stacy, come on.
So the dog that has just kind of a status. So she's the mom to the puppies that we met earlier.
All right. So I wonder, you know, about I've got a comment here. We've got someone tuning in right now saying hello from India, and then we've got somebody else tuning in. And they're saying, thank you so much for the hardworking job you do. It's truly amazing. You're true wildlife heroes. So there's a lot of people tuning in who are very, you know, want to pass on their thanks for the work that you're doing in the conservancy and outside.
We really appreciate everyone who's really touched and are supportive to the work that the conservancy is doing in terms of protection of biodiversity and the empowerment of the communities that surround us. So thank you.
All right, that's great. And then, you know, I wonder if you can talk for a moment about some of the biggest challenges that the canine unit faces. What are some of the biggest challenges that you face?
Biggest challenges.
Now just we have a big challenge, especially since the corona come, because we don't take a lot of time with dogs within the communities, because we don't have more time to take these dogs. So we have a lot of challenges, especially with dogs, and also you have challenges with most of this, especially this breed, is not good when they get 5 years to 6 years, they get a lot of problems like growth, heart attack, cancer. So I think that's a big challenge we have with the dogs here in conservation.
And because of the global pandemic, we've had a financial constraint in terms of keeping up with the operations that we're doing in terms of rhino conservation, keeping up with the armed team and the canine unit. So most of us have been forced to go on pay cuts. So in order to keep all this to run, and we fully appreciate the efforts of Tekeles and other guys who are here, because they're willing to work with minimal pay, so long as the animals are protected and our heritage are safe. So yeah, there's also financial constraints. There's also morally, the world, everyone is like sad. So there's that kind, I don't want to call it depression, but it's depression. So working at such times, it's difficult, and the times are so uncertain and it's new to everyone. So I understand everyone understands what I'm saying.
Yeah, absolutely. No question. And, you know, that just really goes to the passion and the dedication of all the members of the team, the Rangers, the canine unit. And I'm going to share here the website. So to oldpedgeconservancy.org. It's up here on the website. So please do, you know, as people tune in live, as people are tuning into this, watching the recording over the next few months, please do, you know, take a moment, visit the site, learn a little bit more about the conservation work. And of course, if you can, make a contribution to help ensure that this really important work can keep on happening. It's what a great way. This is the second event in the festival of our World Ranger Day Festival. And it's hard to want to go. The dogs are so beautiful. And just watching them, they're so very well trained as well. It's great. Well, Dylan, I want to say a big thanks to you, Dylan. Dylan, thank you for working the camera today. Thank you for hosting the first part of the Q&A and making the great video to show Takalis and the team out on patrol. And Takalis, a big thank you to you. Thank you for joining us today on World Ranger Day. Thank you for your passion and your dedication. Best of luck with the new puppies and out there on patrol and protecting not only the conservancy but also the community as well. So thank you so much, Takalis.
You're welcome.
All right. Well, Dylan, I'm going to let you go for now. There's one more look at Drum. Look at that. And then we'll be coming back to Old Paget a little bit later in the day, 4:30 East African time. We'll take a look at a different aspect. We'll meet some of the rangers who work with the rhino. So we're definitely looking forward to that. But thank you so much for this live event from the canine unit.
Joe, thank you very much for having us, and we appreciate it.
All right. Thank you so much. We'll see you soon.
Bye.
All right. What a just a great opportunity to get to see the canine unit, to get to meet some of the dogs, to meet Takalis. Just a great great work that they're doing at Old Paget Conservancy. We love taking trips there virtually for the festival series. And seeing what they're up to. So I do want to put that link up one more time there to oldpegaconservancy.org. So there we go.